So right here I'm running an ESP E2 M2. It's neck through. Really nice, you know, it's like that see-through black. Just got it not, you know, a couple months ago. It's my first guitar actually with a Floyd Rose. So, you know, I'm getting used to that, but, you know, it's really comfortable. The neck, you know, it's not as thin as something as like an Ibanez or something, but I kind of like that, you know, I like that chunkier neck. Right now these are the EMG 8185s. And then strings, I'm using the D'Addario Pro Steels. Same ones, you know, Hobbs is using. Me and him use basically the same gauge. I only use one string is different. I use a 30 instead of a 26. I use 56, 46, 30, 17, 13, 10. And then Hobbs, he uses a 26 there. I like it a little thicker, a little chunkier. Come over here, I got the pedal board. My homemade pedal board. This right here is through the front of the amp, and then I run this through the back of the amp. So I'm running a Line 6 G50 wireless into the Korg tuner, into a Maxon OD808X. I just got this. I haven't really had that much time to mess with it yet, but this is a really good pedal for going on the road and using stuff like if we don't have our 6505s or other PVs and stuff that don't have enough gain or enough distortion. It's good to like boost it up, give you the juice you want, you know? So then that's going into the decimator, and that's going right into the head, into the 6505 Plus, into the PV cabs, and then actually I have through the back, through the effects loop, I have another decimator. So this one kind of gets rid of like in between like the stops, like the like that. And then like this one gets rid of your tube buzz, like all your like all your sizzle from your tubes. So it makes it really tight, really quiet, you know? And then I got the Maxon 8010 delay. Use that for some of the solo parts, not too often. But it's definitely a good pedal.